Explain inductance in series. Magnetic field is the property which forces us to treat the coil or inductor differently from the resistors and capacitors. We know that a resistor generates no magnetic field and a capacitor generates an electric field that remains internal to the capacitor. Whereas in an inductor, its magnetic field extends beyond itself and can easily overlap the turns of wire in an adjacent coil. It is because of this property that we need to deal with two separate factors when combining inductors in a circuit. The factors are self-inductance and mutual inductance. When two inductors are connected in series, the question that arises is whether or not their magnetic fields interact. When the magnetic fields don't interact, then their inductances are simply added. Thus, the total inductance will be, where L1, L2, and L3 are the inductances of the coil. In this expression, Ln implies that any number of inductors may be used. Consider three inductors connected in series with each other. We see that the current which flows through the first inductor has no other way to go but to pass through the second inductor and then the third inductor. Thus, inductors in series have a common current flowing through them. The definitive measure of inductance is the amount of voltage dropped across an inductor for a given rate of current change through it. So, if inductors are connected together in series, sharing the same current and witnessing the same rate of change in current, then the total voltage dropped as a result of the change in current will be added with each inductor, creating a greater total voltage than either of the individual inductors alone. Taking the value of individual voltage drop across each inductor, total inductance for the series combination will be if we divide this expression by di by dt, we get a final expression for calculating the total inductance. Therefore, the total inductance for series inductors is more than any of the individual inductors' inductance. Thus, inductors are said to be connected in series when they are daisy-chained together, end-to-end in a straight line. Inductors in series are added together as the number of coil turns is effectively increased. Note that this equation holds true only when there is no mutual inductance or magnetic coupling between two or more inductors. When inductors are connected in series in such a way that each of its magnetic field links with the other, then the effect of mutual inductance either increases or decreases the total inductance depending upon the amount of magnetic coupling. The effect of mutual inductance depends upon the distance between the coils. And their orientation to each other. mutually connected inductors in series can be classed as either aiding or opposing the total inductance, depending whether the coils are cumulatively coupled or differentially coupled. Now let's discuss about cumulatively coupled coils. If the magnetic flux produced by the current flows through the coils in the same direction, then the coils are said to be cumulatively coupled. If the current flowing between the points A and D through the two cumulatively coupled coils is in the same direction, then the equation for the voltage drop across each of the coils needs to be modified to take into account the interaction between the two coils due to the effect of mutual inductance. The self-inductance of each individual coil, L1 and L2, will be the same as before, but M, which denotes the mutual inductance, will be added. Thus, the total EMF induced into the cumulatively coupled coils will be, where L1 plus M represents the influence of coils L2 on L1, and L2 plus M represents the influence of coil L1 on L2. And now let's discuss about differentially coupled coils. If the magnetic flux produced by the current flows through the coils in the opposite direction, then the coils are said to be differentially coupled. In this case, same current flows through each coil, but in opposite directions. The EMF induced in coil 1, due to the effect of mutual inductance of coil 2, is in opposition to the self-induced EMF in coil 1. Since same current passes through each coil in opposite directions, so the mutual inductance which exists between the two coils will have a cancelling effect on each coil. The expression to calculate the total inductance of a circuit will become, to take account of this cancelling effect, we use a minus sign with M when the magnetic field of the two coils are differentially connected. Thus, the final equation for inductively coupled inductors in series can be written as, where plus or minus M represents the aiding and opposing mutual inductance. Related term is